Good morning.
Morning, everybody.
Morning.
Good morning.
Morning, everybody.
Morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Do that wonderful thing, which is actually writing on a piece of paper and putting it into a postbox. It's almost a lost art now. You know, when you pack new experiences into as many moments as you can, you kind of weigh time down and it seems to travel slower.
I think it says a lot about me, though, that even though I'm staying in the grounds of a castle, I'm probably more impressed by the fact that they have a resident pedalo.
I arrived at 10:30 in Berg last night in pitch darkness. The guy who ran the hostel had left a message saying, "There's some keys in the letterbox. Place is all yours." Isn't that amazing?
And about 1 meter from the water after that final lock, bearing in mind I've done 45 or 50 different portages, not one, but both wheels fell off. I've traveled here so slowly. 29 days ago, I got in a Hobie kayak for the first time and started pedaling. And now 600 miles later, I'm in Stockholm for the first time in my life. It's such a lovely reward.
This was the section, the open water section, the crossing of the Baltic from Sweden to Åland, Finland. Hairs standing up on my arms and the back of my neck. Tension, nerves, excitement. And if I can see land, it's a long, long way away and it's totally up to me to get there. I love that feeling.
I guess it's maybe a metaphor for life. Sometimes things do fall down, but it's up to us to build them up again.
Man, I feel so at home out here. The first couple of days leaving Oslo, I was really unfamiliar with Hobie, with where everything went, but now I couldn't be more familiar with it. This is truly home. You know, packing up in the morning is just a case of slotting everything into the puzzle, and I kind of know what the puzzle looks like now.
Nini, any advice for wannabe adventurers?
You need to have warm clothes when you come to Finland. Hope this guy gets to Helsinki.
Oh, that's nice.
Safe and sound.
I will. Don't worry.
I will.
The temperature has plummeted to 3 degrees this morning. It was below zero last night. Everything has changed. But now the sun has climbed and inched its way behind a black cloud, which seems to be taking up the majority of the sky. It is exactly 1 week today that I hope to arrive into Helsinki, and I'm not going to do that by just sitting still. There's another metaphor for life for you. I don't know if it's so much about strategy as just perseverance and determination for the rest of this one. Oslo is such a long, long way away. When I started, I couldn't even start to think about Helsinki, what the place looked like, how I'd feel when I got to Finland. But now I'm here, it's just absolutely gorgeous.
But the sun is out, which is great. It's almost a peace of mind. If you capsize, at least you're going to get warm fast.
If there's a sunset going on behind me and I'm still on the water, it probably means I haven't found somewhere to camp yet. But that's okay, because when it's dark, you can camp pretty much anywhere and nobody will find you. It always works out for the best. Always.
There is a goal and there is a purpose. 1,000 miles. There is no way I'm getting to Helsinki on 998. That would be really embarrassing.
5 miles in front of me is Helsinki.
The thing is, I turned up and no one's here. It's really awkward. I had to go around in circles. No, I'm only joking. Look.
Adventure makes us rich. And I don't have any money. Good night.